our operations 24/7 job doesn't stop because we have an incident.
How many people?
Because of our aging infrastructure, we do have a potential for those units and those pieces of equipment to fail.
How much equipment?
I don't have 600-700 feet of hard boom on that trailer to make this happen today.
What would it take to respond to nearly 6,000 gallons of oil spilling into a fast-flowing river? More than 30 people from nearly a dozen agencies gathered on the shore of the Middle Fork Willamette River to get some answers.
We want to understand our limitations and needs in spill response and be able to establish plans that are realistic and effective in the event of an emergency.
The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Portland District and local first responders staged and deployed equipment to battle a mock oil spill just below Dexter Dam, southeast of Eugene, Oregon. This was the first time the agencies put a unified response to the test at a Corps dam. The Corps operates and maintains 13 dams in Oregon's Willamette Valley. The dams provide people in the region many benefits, including flood risk reduction and hydropower. But with the benefits come risks.
So while we do everything we can to engineer out risk and to establish operating procedures to minimize risk, we also have that potential for oil to enter the water.
The Corps has a robust oil spill response and prevention program in place at its dams. Still, resources are limited. A unified, multi-agency response will be essential to mitigate environmental impacts if an oil spill were to happen.
And they have emergency deployment assets, spill boom, command centers, training and expertise that can be deployed quickly in the event of a large-scale spill.
This exercise was an opportunity to take full inventory of resources available in the event of a major spill, put them to the test, and identify potential improvements. During the exercise, teams on each side of the river and in a boat strung a cable across the Middle Fork Willamette River. Once in place, the cable was used to deploy a spill containment boom across the water. It was a challenging task.
We've learned that, you know, deploying something like this in these kind of currents and these flows takes a lot more resources and a lot more equipment than we initially thought.
We're committed to doing everything we can to keep oil out of the environment. We recognize our risks and liabilities, and we're working with other agencies to develop effective response plans in the event that something unforeseen does happen.
Wilson said the next step is to apply what they learned to the Corps' emergency response plan and continue practicing.
Because we're really going to need the help of everybody to get something like this mitigated for and protect the environment.
In Portland, Oregon, I'm Michelle Helms.